Sound design.
So what are the optimal settings for Smaart so that you can quickly get a handle on taking readings and not micromanage too much? This is one of the biggest problems with having so much data is that we want to micromanage, but we can help ourselves avoid that with a few simple settings here. So I'm going to go through these quickly, not getting into too much detail, but here's how I recommend you start with your brand new Smaart setup. The first thing we're going to want to do is change the y-axis settings of our magnitude graph here. So go to Options, Transfer Function, and set your magnitude range to minimum negative 18, maximum 18. Set your grid interval to 6. The grid interval of 3 just kind of is a little bit annoying to me, and 6 is a very important number for the kind of work we're going to be doing, and it's a division that I want to be really clear. You can set your coherence on or off. Just get used to using the C key a lot to turn the coherence on and off. You see, like, okay, I see it. I know this is a problem. Great, turn it off. Over here on the right, start with averaging at 1 second. If you are outside or there's a lot of noise, you may have to turn it up to 3 or 4. There's no problem with turning this up as much as you want. You can even set it to infinity and just let it run. And as soon as you get enough good data, you stop it. Start with your phase response, your phase smoothing at 1/24th octave and your magnitude smoothing at 1/48th. Resist the urge to set this really high. That makes it pretty, but it's a lie. I will put a link to my interview with Mauricio Ramirez under this video, and we go into detail about why you don't want to use a lot of smoothing when you are doing this kind of work. The next thing I would get familiar with is your zoom presets and your view presets. Now, I don't know all the view presets, but I know the ones that are important to me. So what happens to me a lot of times is that I'm in spectrum view, I hit T to go back to transfer function view, and then the phase graph is on top and the magnitude graph is on bottom. But I started out using Sat Live for a long time, so I'm used to the magnitude trace being on top. So I just remember to hit the number 6, and that gets me back to magnitude trace on top, phase on the bottom. That's what I'm used to seeing. And you can take a look at those under View, View Presets, and you can change those to whatever you want. Options, Zoom. I have these set up like this because I want to quickly be able to zoom into certain areas. And the most important for me are probably this area between 30 to 200 and 2000 to 10,000. Those two areas I find myself zooming in and out of often, so I can quickly look at the subs and then come back to zoomed out and then maybe look at just the high end if I'm doing aiming a speaker and then quickly zoom out. So these are not the default settings. So this is what I recommend. Zoom 1, 30 to 200, zoom 2, 200 to 2000, zoom 3, 2K to 10K, zoom 4, 10K to 20K. So here's what I was talking about. Option 1, quickly zoom in, look at the subs, and then I'll usually just click out here to zoom out. Okay, otherwise that'd be option 5. Option 3, this is my 2K to 10K. I know just because of my own hearing loss and my own disability that there's a lot of things above 12K that I just can't hear. So zooming into 4K is an important area for me to be able to check out if there's something crazy happening up here that I may not even be able to hear, but I can see it on the graph. This clicking out here to reset to default is super powerful because a lot of times you'll mess up this graph, like you move it around with the arrow keys. If you need to see something, you zoom in here, you move around, you right click and zoom way into this thing. Anywhere you are, you can always click out here and get back to default. Okay, same thing in the phase graph down here. You may use the arrow keys to move this around so it's easier to read. You may zoom in like this. Anytime you need to get back to normal, just click there. And then the final setting I recommend is start with your signal generator at minus 12 dB. More on why that is in future videos. Okay, so those are the default settings that I recommend. If you guys have any suggestions for me, please comment below this video.
Sound design.